കേരള ബ്ലാസ്റ്റേഴ്സിനെ ഐ എസ് എൽ ഫൈനലിലെത്തിച്ച ജനകീയ പരിശീലകൻ ഇവാൻ വുക്കോമനോവിച്ച് 3 വർഷം കൂടി ക്ലബിൽ തുടരുമെന്ന പ്രഖ്യാപനം ആവേശത്തോടെയാണ് ആരാധകർ ഏറ്റെടുത്തിരിക്കുന്നത്. 2025 വരെ ബ്ലാസ്റ്റേഴ്സിനൊപ്പം ഉണ്ടാകുമെന്ന സ്ഥിരീകരണത്തിന് ശേഷം യൂറോപ്പിൽ നിന്ന് നമ്മുടെ ആശാൻ ആദ്യമായി വിശദമായ അഭിമുഖത്തിനായി ചേരുകയാണ് ഏഷ്യാനെറ്റ് ന്യൂസിൽ. ഹായ് കോച്ച്, ഗ്രേറ്റ് ടു സീ യു അഗെയിൻ. വാട്ട്സ് ഗോയിങ് ഓൺ? വേർ ആർ യു? ഹൗ ആർ യു?
Everything's all right. Everything's great. I'm at home in Belgium, in the city where I live, Antwerp. And actually, everything's all right. It's not that, let's say, nice weather like in India. I prefer that Indian heat. But anyway, it's nice because now here we are in the part where actually the competitions are about to end. Here in Belgium, the playoffs just started. And there are many interesting games. So I'm around at the stadiums, watching games, you know, being part of European football, actually. Most probably I will be going to see some European games. Last night and the last days, I couldn't do that. But probably for the return games, I will be probably on some stadiums.
Among the top European clubs, which is your favorite team? Which club do you support?
Actually, now... You know, the only club I support is Kerala Blasters. You know, now in European football, I like to watch a great game. You know, I like them all, bringing good football, showing great things, great skills, nice goals, attacking football.
I'm surprised that you are busy watching football and all. I was under the impression that you had switched off completely and were enjoying the break.
Yes, sometimes it happened. Sometimes it happened, you know. But anyway, that's the life. They all know that. Look, I started playing professionally I was really young, 1994. I just turned 17 years old when I started playing as a professional football player. You know, the phone can ring and in 2 days you can find yourself at the other part of the globe. So this is how it is. So they're used to that and, you know, it's great. It's great to have that kind of support.
So what did you tell your family about us, about Kerala? Did you teach them any Malayalam words like "Keri vada makale"?
I told my family actually all the best, and honestly, I can't wait to get back there to Kochi because I miss that environment. And actually, they are so happy because they see me smiling, they see me happy being there, you know, being part of that. And it's a great energy, you know, it's a great energy. They are all so happy and. Most probably some of them will come to visit me.
And now, congratulations, coach. 3 more years, that's a long time in football.
Yeah, we say that's a longer during contract. But you know, in football, the things, they go really fast. Sometimes it happens that you don't stay long enough. Sometimes you extend even after that. You know, it depends on the feeling. And since we started, I was mentioning that a couple of times in our... meetings, let's say interactions, that I'm really happy. We had a deal actually even earlier, but we wanted to wait that the competition is done and that we sit down easy with you know, with the mind clear, and that was it. I think that everybody's happy. Me, the first one.
I'm excited to see you in white shirt. Are you planning to bring more white shirts to Kochi?
Always. No. We're going to find the new white shirts in Kochi. Most probably there will be some action organized, but white shirt will be present at the stadium. That's for sure.
Coach, your stump speech or often repeated statement in the previous season was, we all should stay humble. We should not say big words. Remember where we finished last season and all. But now the rhetoric needs to be changed. Going into the next season, we are one of the finalists.
We will stay humble. We will work hard because we want to be on top. You know, every team now, especially, you know, we're not what they expected last year us to see us top of the table, especially not in finals. Now it gives us kind of a good feeling like, okay, it is possible. You know, when you work hard, when you work correctly, and when you have all heads towards the same direction, then you can achieve nice things. So these kind of topics will be in our stories, in our interactions in the next period. And then, of course, we know that Kerala Blasters is the team that everybody wants to beat because it gives something special. You know, I think that nobody in India in Indian football, ISL has what KBFC has. So in that case, but we are very happy. I'm glad that we will be playing in front of our stadium.
When are you coming to Kerala? Tell us about your pre-season plans. I understand that this squad will be going to Europe.
Yeah, of course. We already talked even before we ended up our last season in Goa, and later on in our meetings, we communicated that we will start again a little bit earlier. Okay, last season we started earlier in August. I think that now, depending, we are just waiting the confirmation from an ISL side board when exactly the competition will start. So in that case, we will decide, and most probably we'll take again, you know, at least two and a half months of preseason, and most probably I will be coming in Kochi somewhere in July, hopefully half July already, starting preseason. We want to go abroad. We want to put our team most probably to go on European tour on preseason to put our team in a kind of difficult situation, facing and playing many friendly games against European top sides, you know, good teams. Because we want them to feel what does it mean playing against top level? What does it mean when you are in difficulties? Because like that, you can improve. So, and the, most probably the first part will stay in Kochi, then later on we'll be moving abroad. Still, it's to be defined where it will be, if it will be Europe or somewhere else. And of course, later on, we'll be coming back to Kochi before the competition, probably, most probably with one or two really good friendly games in our stadium against top teams, or even maybe against the national team. We'll see how it's the situation in that period. And then starting the ISL.
Many from the senior squad are playing the Development League. Are you following KBFC games?
Every game, yes. Yes, I'm following our boys. I'm very glad that they are in a team. I'm very glad that they accepted and went to play, because everybody must know the youth development league and the youth process, the youth period is the most important part of a football player's life. Everybody must understand that, because the period that you spend between, let's say, 15 and 19, 20 years old, that's the most important part in your football life.
Five Blasters players, Gil, Sahil, Rahul, Khabra and Jikson, were named among the probables for AFC Asian Cup. Club must be happy about it.
Well, first of all, I'm very proud. I'm very proud of those boys, really, and they deserved it. If we see the totality of the competition that and the games that these guys, not only those guys, but, you know, all the guys from our team that they were playing, I think that they deserve to be there. And I think that the coach, Timats, knows his job. He was watching all the games of ISL last season. And again, I'm proud of those boys, because they showed great quality. They showed great commitment to the team, and they're bringing something extra.
Coach, if I ask you to name a couple of players who made tremendous improvement or rapid improvement during the previous season.
You can say better, comparing maybe to previous seasons, how they improved, if they improved. So, you know, we were just witnessing that one season. You know, maybe after next season, we will be saying, okay, they improved comparing to that season. But I think that many of them, they became more mature. They became more conscious about importance of their role.
As the head coach, you must have identified areas where we need improvement as a team. What are the expectations regarding new transfers, fresh recruitments?
No, but actually every team, you know, every team and us want to improve in every possible aspect. You know, now depending on the transfer market, depending on the situations, because sometimes you plan to sign foreign players. Sometimes you plan to sign domestic players. And then just suddenly from nowhere, a possibility opens. Because last season, if we go back, you know, nobody knew nothing about Adrian Luna or Jorge or Marko Lešković. You know? And these kind of things, when it happened in the transfer window, when you sign those players and they come and they perform, everybody's happy. So we are very happy about all of them. So now we will continue, you know, building up further on, trying to add again something extra. We'll see. hopefully that you'll again have a very strong Kerala Blasters.
Since this is our first exclusive interaction after the final, I would like to ask one question about some decisions made during the final. Why did you withdraw some experienced foreign players just before the penalty shootout?
If we speak about substitution, about Jorge and Jorge Diaz and Alvaro Vasquez,
yeah,
both of them, they had injury problems. You know, that's why we changed them. Otherwise, they would have stayed on a pitch till the end, shooting penalties as well. But they had muscle troubles. You know, it was exhausting period from January. So then about the penalties, at the moment when it happened, you know, you just approached that, you know. I was asking, is there anyone who wants to shoot the penalty? Many of them, they volunteers said, yeah, they want to shoot. So that was it. That was it. Adrian Luna, he wanted to shoot the last one, the fifth one. So that's how we manage it. You know, that was it. Hard pill to swallow. But anyway, that's football. That's life. We have to continue because, like I said, that was the example that showed us that it's possible, you know. So now it's about, let's continue working hard. Let's go again. Let's do it again.
Absolutely, coach. We trust you and looking forward to the next one. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Javi. Thank you. All the best. See you soon.